Hello viewers, welcome to my channel iTech Solution. Today I will discuss on SQL Server, one important topic, relationship between two tables. And in this process, I have created a database called appointment. And in this database, I have tables, showing tables. And I want to make a relationship between suppose user login table and appointment details table. So first of all, what is relationship and what are the process of relating two things? You see, this is my formation of table. And here one concept is there, one primary key field is there, where one common field should be in the both table. And this table I want to show here is suppose this is your user ID, which I have to impose primary key. And this is the primary key, and here I have set this primary key for this field user ID. Primary key is the concept where no duplicate value is allowed in this field, because one ID is common to all people, so one unique user ID will be accepted here in this table. So no duplicate value is allowed here. This is the this is called also a constraint. So primary key has another facility, is that it should not allow blank field. It should not allow to allow null. So here it is unchecked here. So these two constraint is imposed. One is unique number is accepted in this entire table, and other is no null value is accepted. So introduction of these things, I want to show the another table, user login, and I right click on this and go to the modify. Here is also user ID, and this user ID is also same as that of the appointment details table user ID. So here is this open here, this is user ID same, and this user ID is same of common. So now I think it is ready to connect these things, these two tables. And now I have to show what is relationship. Relationship is that I want to relate this common field of both the table to connect each other. The relationship implies that this field of every row corresponds to the another field of that row. That is, if there is a unique ID, then there should be unique rows in that table also, the second table also. And if in case this UID is updated, I am to change this UID, then there will be change in the second table also. So this is the constraint in both the table, and acting as the updation of field in the both tables. If suppose I want to remove one record of this first table, suppose user login table, then the record of that table or that field, that rows will also be deleted from the second table. This is called the deletion constraint. So now I will go to the how this relationship is created. First of all, I close these tables. I go to the database design, the database diagram option. Here I right click on this database diagram and new database diagram, and here I will add these tables. Suppose this one is that and second one is that, so both table is there. And now I want to create a relationship between these tables, so I drag and drop this field, this user login to this field. See here, I will get it. Drag and this fill to this fill. Yeah, this key is drag and drop this fill. It is not open. Yes, it is acting. User login table and a primary login. User ID is connected to this. So in case of this primary key, then its second key is called foreign key of the table. Okay. So in this options, the design of this for relationship is prepared, and now the two options is selected here. One is delete rules, second is update rules. That I have already discussed that the updation of both the table is both the rows of table is appropriately acted on the related field, and deletion rule says the deleted column or deleted rows of the first table will apply to delete of the second from the second table also. That is, one UID is deleted from the first table, then automatically second table will be row will be deleted from that corresponding rows of that table. So this is called the cascading option here. This is called cascading. You select here option this cascade. This also the select option cascade, which will allow us to acted the two rule already discussed earlier, and click on OK. Now it is connected from user ID to user ID. So I think it is sufficient to you that to how the relationship diagram is prepared in SQL Server Management Studio. Thank you. If this is liked by you, please click on the like button and subscribe for more videos from now. Thank you.